Hello there, how are you doing? Welcome back to Slam Motion. So guys, in today's video, we are going to discuss how do critics and viewers feel about Justin Hartley's The Noel Diary. Are you guys excited? So let's get started. So keep up with me till the end, comment right below this video, subscribe if you still haven't, and turn on the post notification for more videos. The Noel Diary has received decent reviews so far. With 14 reviews in, The Noel Diary has received a 71% rating on Rotten Tomatoes, although that can drastically change in the coming weeks. There is praise for the film's heartwarming story itself, which is based on a book of the same name by Richard Paul Evans. Some even believe that the film would work even if it's not set during the holidays. Ditch the mistletoe and holly, and it would still be a well-crafted, well-balanced character sketch, following two lost souls as they discover what they've been missing, the Los Angeles Times wrote. The New York Times said, director Charles Shire brings a journeyman's ease to the screenplay, based on Richard Paul Evans' novel of the same name, embracing holiday movie expectations here, gently deflecting them there. Meanwhile, because the movie veers toward drama, many believed it proved to be an ideal project for Hartley after This Is Us, as the New York Times notes that the actor is no stranger to the themes of The Noel Diary. The journey of adoptees, the tug of interracial connections, and the repercussions of a family tragedy should ring a welcome bell for fans of NBC's wonderfully weepy melodrama. Some viewers appreciated the film's depth and soul. True enough, there are viewers who appreciated how The Noel Diary stands out from holiday films. Not your typical Christmas movie, a range of emotions, highs and lows, one reviewer wrote on Rotten Tomatoes, especially to do with the unknown whereabouts of her mother. The Noel Diary is the heartwarming movie of the holiday season, another said. Charles Shire beautifully crafts a melodramatic tale that feels fresh and is the perfect movie to watch with your family during this holiday season. There were also some praises for Hartley and Barrett Doss, who played his love interest, Rachel, in the film. Justin Hartley does a great job as usual. This was my first time to see Barrett Doss in a film, and I was pleased with her acting, a user wrote on Rotten Tomatoes. In all, this film takes you on a bit of a roller coaster, but in the end, if you have watched romantic Christmas movies in the past, they all come out exactly the way you think they will. Others accuse The Noel Diary of promoting adultery and depression. On the other hand, some are taking issue with the film's story, claiming that it's just too sad for Christmas. This is not a Christmas movie, one reviewer on Metacritic even claimed. It's not a rom-com, it's a depressing, poorly written, plot hole-filled waste of time. Dead mom, dead brother, father he hasn't seen in 30 years. This is depressing, as the plot holes are huge, and it just doesn't make any dom sense. The girl doesn't even meet her birth mother, the main point of the dom movie. This is such a bad, bland, boring waste of time. Don't bother watching. One of the worst Christmas sick movies I have ever watched. Painful to sit through, deeply regret watching, feeling blindsided and disturbed that this was number one on Netflix, Rotten, a user also wrote on Rotten Tomatoes. Another said, who thought it was a good idea to base a Christmas rom-com in the middle of two hugely traumatic storylines? Sick, the actors did the best they could, but come on Netflix, that was a trash script. On the other hand, some also took issue with Doss' character cheating on her fiancé Alan, Mike Donovan, while she was on a road trip with Jacob. On Rotten Tomatoes, one user wrote the film offered a thought-provoking story on adultery. I thought it was a Christmas movie, but actually ends up about Rachel. She is bored with her relationship. She meets Jacob, an attractive man on the road. She has an affair with him. She tells him and us that she wanted to sleep with him as soon as she saw him. On Reddit, some viewers are calling out the film, accusing it of promoting adultery. The love story is between a nasty cheater and the dullest, saddest man on earth. Really? Netflix? Please stop romanticizing cheating, it's disgusting, one user wrote. Another Redditor said, hard to root for half of the story when they really don't provide any reason for us to have anything against Alan. Rachel just comes off as someone who was being super shifty around her fiancé and would throw away her relationship at the first sign of someone better. So guys, this was all about today's video. Share as much as you can, that really motivates us to create more content for you guys. With this, we end our video. Hope you liked the video.